Yes, ma'am, it is
I
audible.
have enabled the recording, so we can start with the session. Lobo sir, okay, Naik sir, shall we start? Manisha ma'am, Katote sir, yeah, okay.
Yes, madam. Yes.
So shall we start, sir? Yeah, Lobo sir is there. Shall we start,
Yes.
sir?
Yes, madam. Yes.
Okay, so yeah, Prathamesh, you can start now.
Good morning, WIT. I, Prathamesh Vishnu Prasad Puranik, coordinator of the today's event, welcome you all in the first virtual mini project idea presentation round one.
Prathamesh, your video is not visible. Share the video.
Now
Facebook.
it is visible.
Okay. Yeah, continue. Sorry.
So welcome you all. We'll start the presentation. Before going to the presentation, the short brief introduction will be given by Prem Shah. Prem Shah.
Thank you, Prathamesh. Good morning to one and all. As we all know that during this pandemic, we have been stuck in our cities for over a year and have not been able to get back to the college. But today, I would like to take the opportunity to thank our teachers who not only work hard, but also keep us guiding on the way, right from teaching us everything we need to the placement preparations, which would help us build our future. We have gathered here today for the first round of evaluation for our mini projects. So without wasting time further, I, Prem Shah, welcome all the faculty members and students present over here to this virtual meeting for the evaluation and presentation of our project ideas. I further hand over to Prathamesh Puranik again. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Prem. Okay, we'll start the presentation. Once I will start, you have to be ready. Like the first team, that is mine itself, that is team number one, group leader Prathamesh Puranik, presenter Prathamesh Puranik, and guided by Dr. S.S. Gajbar, sir. So I will start the presentation. And after that, team number two has to be ready for the next. Yes, my screen is visible. Anyone can tell me? Hello?
Yes, Prathamesh. Yes.
Yes. So, shall I start? Okay, I will start. Hello, all. Under the software web app development technology bucket, our objective of the project is to design and develop a web application to provide smart and secure electoral services. So basically, why we have chosen the topic? I will tell some points regarding to it. So all of you know that there is a pandemic COVID-19 situation. So it is very, very useful. And elections are most neglected topic among us. And also there are some drawbacks of the current system. And one of the important thing is that our Prime Minister Modi sir dream towards the Atmanirbhar Bharat will be achieved through this project. And also there is one research is going on with the help of IIT Madras and IIT Bombay to conduct a digitalized elections in 2024. So basically our project has following solutions. So it will provide user-friendly web portal for voter registration, election creation through admin management. It conducts fair, transparent, cost-effective, time-saving election with less manpower and reduces voter dropouts. It provides high security with the help of OTP and email verification. It provides faster calculation of votes, which leads to eliminating delays in the declaration of results with detailed analysis. So basically, what is existing system is? Yes, it is. There are some disadvantages with the existing system. As we all know, existing system is associated with the EVM and VVPAT. One of the biggest challenge of booth-based voting system is that a voter has to be physically present to vote. This leads to low voter turnout, which affects good democracy. Missing of names in the voter list, technical problems are also associated with the EVM. And EVM requires huge manpower, a space to store the EVMs for counting purpose. Conducting such elections is highly expensive and time consuming, and security may glitch also. So all of us know the existing voting process scenario. First, we have to go to the booth, then voter ID verification, then officer mark on the left forefinger, then voter cast a vote through the EVM and vote will be recorded. This all we know. Then what is our system architecture? This is our proposed system architecture. It is a basic architecture, first of all. We will advance the things in it. So basically, user has to first come onto the our web portal. Then there is a homepage provided on it. Then there is separate login for the user and admin. Firstly, user has to be registered through this portal. If he has registered, he can directly log in. If he has not registered, he has to first register. And the whatever the information will be given by the user, that information, that credentials will be verified by the admin at the data through the database, and then only the registrations are approved by the admin. And after that, user can log in through that portal. He can view his profile. He can update, delete his profile. And also, the at the time of election, he can log in and he can vote for a candidate. That is, voting for only one time in the election is done by the voter. The purpose of the admin has a right to conduct and generate the election. He has to approve the registrations of the user, and he has a right to show the results publicly. That is very important. This is the meaning of transparency in our system. All these things are done using the central database. So what is the future scope of our electoral services? That I'll also tell. So like web application, we will create easy to use mobile voting technology platform, which is very, very useful. We will provide multi-layer security by face recognition, Aadhaar-based biometric authentication by using AI and ML technology. So we will use blockchain technology. In the future, this platform will be available for foreign types of voting, like political voting, shareholder voting, housing society voting, corporate association, back sector voting, and also customers, students voting and feedbacks, and live polls are also present. So these are some future scope of electoral services. For creating such project, we are using this technology stack, like we are using Python language. By using Visual Studio, we'll build a project. We are using HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript at the front end, Django framework at the back end, and SQLite3, which is inbuilt database in the Django framework we are using. So the Django framework, that is the reason it is most secure framework of the Python that we can use at the back end. And dependability, it is according to client's requirements. And these are some references that you can refer to. So at the end, I will say that to achieve 100% voting, we will be trying to build a next big thing in the business, but smart and secure electoral services. Thank you. Okay, is team tool is ready? So
any questions the guide has, you can ask, please.
Yes, yes.
We have 5 minutes for presentation, and if at all, like some questions, we can go for max 5 minutes by the guides. So Lobo sir, all the faculty, if any questions, you can ask the students, so that if not, then we can move to the next presentation.
Yeah, I have a question actually.
Yes.
Are you going to do the face recognition currently in this particular project?
No, ma'am. It is for the major project we proposed that idea, because
how you will make sure that there will be only one vote from the particular person right now?
Yes, ma'am, we are using OTP and email verification for that. OTP will be sent to the email, and according to that, it will be verified.
It means that the voting will be based on the mobile. So if I'll use two mobiles, I can do the two votings currently.
No, ma'am, particular voter has to register by only one mobile, that is the unique for that voter, and we will also provide one unique identification.
How you will make sure that I have not done two registrations with two email IDs and two mobile numbers?
Yes, ma'am, because we will verify that user, no?
So currently you are doing only the registration part, and then you are based on the registration you are doing it. See, unless and until you will make the unique identification.
Yes, ma'am. Voter ID is the unique, no?
No, that's what I'm saying.
I think you have to send the OTP to to that mobile number, which mobile number has to be mapped with the UID.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And you don't consider other mobile number.
Yes, yes. Miss, once
so
I have
that
told
is the unique identification.
For one voter, one mobile number is allocated.
No, better you take the Aadhaar card number for this, as he said.
Okay.
Otherwise, it will be difficult because a person can have n number of mobiles and n number of, even we can write a program to have the mobile numbers and send directly the voting and all.
Okay.
So it should be attached to unique ID only.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. I will use Aadhaar card. Okay.
Prathamesh.
Yes.
Even some of the organization, they are working on this topic and using the blockchain technology for the security.
Yes, sir. So that is the proposed at the future scope, sir. Because currently we are not familiar with the blockchain. We are going to learn it and we will implement in this project. Okay, sir.
Lobo, sir, any questions? I just request the faculties, like just for 10 minutes, within 10 to 15 minutes, I'll share the sheet as I'm logged into through different units. So I'll just share it with one of the setup laptop that I'm setting up. So shall we go with the next presentation now? Any questions?
Okay, next group.
Yeah,
yes,
next.
Yes.
Okay. So the next team, Vishwanath Londe's team, team number 2. Presentation done by Ishita Jain and Arya Aurangabadkar under the guidance of Professor A.K. Naik, sir. Thank you. Arya?
Yes. Shall I present?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Yeah, don't ask for shall I present everybody. Once your turn comes, you directly share the screen.
Okay, ma'am. Is it visible?
Yes.
Yes, you can start.
Okay. Good morning, one and all. As we are going on with the online examination process nowadays, and there we need to have some best portal, which we are going to design today. So our topic is online examination portal, which is a web application prototype. Our group members consist of me, myself, that is Arya Aurangabadkar, Meet Haria, Ishita Jain, Vishwanath Londe, and Vishwajit Sahu. Firstly, the main objective of our this project is that we have to design and develop a automated web application for proctored examination portal. The existing system that some of the systems on online application means online based examination portal does not have all the things which we need. Some may not have the automation result generation, some may not have plagiarism check, while some may don't have the result analysis, some may not have integrated competitive programming platform and also non-proctored platform. So to overcome all these things, we need to go through the best platform which we are going to design and cover the all disadvantages of disadvantages which we face in the online examination. So our basic main solution to all these things we have is that there are many existing platforms nowadays, but we need to modify them and come out of the best version. So the main solution of our platform is that we have a strict plagiarism check. That is, in short answers, some may have copy and write the answers, but copy and paste is not allowed. And secondly, we have to check whether the answer is same or not. The plagiarism is on, so we can find out who is copying and who is not. So second, I come to the point that is structure and normalization database. We have a good database for our platform, which we are going to see in the next slide. Next, I come to simple interface between teachers and students. This is the platform where it is good and simple. Many teachers and students can come out with their own things, means that teachers can upload their question paper, which may consist of an MCQ question paper or question and answer type. Then next is fast and easy evaluation. Evaluation process is going to be a bit modified, and overall it will be a best thing in the project. And also there will be various availability of examination patterns. That is, I told you, it may be MCQ type or it may be an question answer type. Various platforms for various availability of patterns will be available for examination patterns. Next, I hand over it to Ishita. Ishita will continue the rest. Thank you.
So I'm Ishita. Good morning, all. And this is the architecture of our system. As in the center, we can see there is a block called examination portal, which have two blocks, account and students. So when we enter in our system, then but if we log in through an enrollment number and password of student, then automatically the student space will open where they have to give the exam or take the part in the competition, whatever is scheduled. Or if it is of teacher, then automatically teacher's page will open. In students, we can see there are three blocks, year one, year two, year three. That is, we are gonna save the information of all the students of year one, year two, year three. Now one can ask why we have made three tables, year one, year two, year three. It's just the information of students. We could have saved it in only one table. Then why three? So why three? Because let us assume we are only talking about IT, and IT in IT section in first year, there are 70 students. Then what about the 3 years, 17 to three? So if in future we want to know the information of a particular student, then we have to run the query in 70 into 3, then the query time will increase. So here, to make all this process really fast and executable, we have divided the student's info into three different blocks, that is year one, year two, year three. That will be three different tables. On the right hand side, we can see there is a block of student, subject. In subject, we are gonna see.
Yes, 5 minutes are over. You can cover fastly.
Okay. So here's the information. Now
please restrict to the time limit. Please restrict to the time limit.
Okay.
Conclude within 20.
In the registration also, we will be allowed to pay the fees in registration portal only, whether it is a competitive or any other. Next slide, please. These are the technologies we are going to use, that are JavaScript and ExpressJS, ReactJS, API Python. Why all this? Because JavaScript has everything. JavaScript is now, according to GitHub, is the most used platform, and it's very fast executing. Highlighting features of JavaScript and other technologies like PHP, Django do not offer all these. They lag behind in some scenarios. That's why we are using JavaScript. For database, MySQL, which is very popular and very good for this platform. And web application, Python. Why Python? Because for many purposes like proctored and plugin, we are going to use Python. So this is all we want to say. Thank you.
Thank you, Ishita and Arya.
Ishita.
Yes, sir.
Actually, as per our discussion, it was automation of the examination system. As the institutes, like in the last year before the pandemic, as you are done the examination system, it was a manual. And as per our discussion, it was automation of the examination system. And I think you people have changed the topic. It is proctored.
No, sir, we haven't changed the topic. This is an automation examination portal. We have added some features.
Yeah, no, you are actually working on one particular module, okay? But actually the thing is that you need to work on the automation of the examination system, like generating the reports, then examination type, and the time allotment of rooms, hall ticket generation, and all, okay?
Okay, so, sir. Some things we have missed. We will definitely include that.
Yeah, you need to do some more survey. Okay, sir.
We'll try.
So, any suggestions from other faculty?
Actually, sir, two teams are working on now the examination cell process over there. Okay. So we have to sync with them if they also want to do the same thing, because I was thinking they are developing the proctored examination system. And that's why the questions were regarding the proctored examination, because you have not mentioned any hardware part or how you are going to deal with the camera and so on in your system. But now if the topic is going to be changed, and we can discuss afterwards also.
Yeah, we can integrate the different modules. Yes.
Yeah, because already now I have assigned this task to my two teams over there.
Okay.
Any faculty has any suggestions, or shall I continue for with the next team? So one announcement is there. Please, all of you have to finish your presentation only in 5 minutes. We have a time constraint. Please note that. So team number 3, Abhishek Gauri's team, under the guidance of Professor P.N. Kathavte sir, presenter is Vishwanath Kundeli. Yes. Vishwanath?
Yes, just a second. I'm trying to present the screen here.
Yes, okay.
Can you see the screen?
Yes, you can share.
Yes.
It is visible.
So my name is Vishwanath Gundeli, and our team's name is Straw Hat, and our guide is Professor Kathavte sir, and our objective is to create an education resource sharing website using Django. So basically what we are going to do is we are going to create a blog for students where they can resolve their queries. The queries can be anything related to coding, interview, or any kind of technological queries that they have. And we can also share resources with everyone using this blog instead of using WhatsApp, because we don't need a phone number to share resources here. And once if someone has some kind of update or can add something to the existing resource, what they can do is they can just repost that resource with an updated tag. So this will ensure that the next person that is going to access it will always get the updated resource. So this is just like one of the function of GitHub, where we'll access the repository with a pull request, and then we'll again give that to the user. And so one of the aim of creating the blog is also to increase the interaction between the students among them and with the faculty as well. And what problem that I find nowadays is that many students have queries, but they are not asking the queries, and this will just give the doubt in their mind, which may make a setback in the future. And one of the existing system and most popular one is Stack Overflow. And as we all know, the Stack Overflow has many queries and the solution related to that. But Stack Overflow cannot answer the college specific queries that the students have, which may be regarding Moodle or anything, the project related queries. And one of the things about Stack Overflow is also that the queries may be outdated, or the thread to that query is closed. So for example, if you're going to search for something, then you may find the solution on the Stack Overflow, but it may be a couple of years outdated one, and it may not work in the present time. So also using Stack Overflow, we cannot interact with other people that much, as one of our aim is also to have interaction among student and faculty. I believe that interaction is always a good thing. And the existing system architecture that is there are mainly 3 things. One is super admin, system user, and blogger. And we are mainly focusing on the blogger here. So if a blogger has some kind of queries that they want to resolve, then first what they can do is they can just search the blog to see that where there are similar queries. And if there are some kind of similar queries, then they can just view the comments of the blog. If the query is still not resolved, then he can just post a blog and create a category related one. And as soon as someone will see that post, they can just resolve the queries by making a comment. And it need not be a student or a faculty specific. Anyone who knows the solution to the query can just comment it. And the future scope of this project, we have one plan in mind, that to create a text editor, I mean coding editor, in the blog itself, where students can run their code then and there. And also, one thing is that we would like to replace Moodle the editor in the Moodle, because I find it really difficult to use Moodle. And nowadays, during the company's test, some of the editors are designed in such a way that we cannot copy paste the code. I would really like to replicate that and use that in the blog. That is the future scope of our project. And the technology stack that we are going to use is mainly HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap for the front end. For the back end is purely Python, and we're going to use framework of Django. And database, we are going to use SQLite 3 with a Visual Studio Code as the editor. So thank you, that's all.
Okay, thank you, Vishwanath.
Yeah, who will be contributing to this? All the complete globe?
Yes, ma'am.
Who will be contributing on that questions?
Right now, mainly. Mainly me.
No, I could not get your answer.
Right now, mainly, I will answer all the queries that you have.
No. When you're developing this system, a particular student or any user can have the question or can pose the question. So
yes,
you will be okay. As an administrator, you will be answering the questions or anyone.
Not as an administrator, actually. I forgot to mention that there is also login. We are going to validate the user based on the enrollment ID to be. So it is only like institute level blog. I'm trying to create just an institute level blog.
Okay.
So users can register using the enrollment ID.
No, that is one thing. So a particular user will register and will post particular queries. Who will be answering that queries as a system?
Well, ma'am, this is just like a social media one. I mean, everyone can just go through the blog every day and they can just check whether there's some kind of updates and all. So it is just a...
No. My question is that all the registered users can again reply on the questions which has been raised by the others.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Absolutely.
Okay. And you are talking about the editor. So what kind of languages that you are thinking of supporting?
Ma'am, the languages that are mainly used in our college, like Python, C++, Java, C, that would be the first priority. And if we can add, we'll also add C#. Mainly the languages that are mostly in demand.
Okay, but you have to think a lot because creating a text
editor, which is why it's a difficult task.
You have
to make a lot of containers.
See, when you are going for a project, you have to see both the things, feasibility also and the features or the novelty also.
Yes, ma'am, which is why we have kept that as a feature scope.
Check about the feasibility.
Yes, ma'am.
You check about the feasibility. Yeah, of course, it is afterwards for the next year project. Yes. That's fine.
Yes, ma'am. Are there any other questions that anyone would like to ask?
I don't think so.
Okay. So next team, that is both two teams, be ready. That is first team is Prem Shah's team. Presenter is Amit Loni and Madhuri Kalani's team. Presenter Madhuri itself and under the guidance of Mrs. M. A. Nirgude ma'am. Please share your presentation.
Okay. So let us start with the presentation of our group. The objective of our project is to design and develop a desktop application for examination process. The thought behind this topic and objective was, as we all know, that initially our college was affiliated to Solapur University. And now since we are on the process of being an autonomous college, as well as looking at the current situation of the pandemic, we thereby felt need to develop a dedicated system for the examination process. The solutions that we are trying to provide using this system are as follows. Our solution comprises mainly of five major modules. The first module is the student registration module. In the registration module, the students will be able to register to the application and the credentials will be collected in this module for the further logins. The second module consists of exam form. This module consists of a form where in the personal data, as well as the data such as the department, year, and the course regarding the exam the student is going to appear will be collected. The third module comprises of the marks filling. Once the exam form is filled, then the faculty can fill the ISA, ISC, as well, and the internal marks as well. The fourth module comprises of hall ticket. Once the ISC and ISA marks are included in the system, the details in the exam form, then the hall tickets are generated by the exam cell for every individual student. The fifth module is of generation of results by the exam cell. Once the hall tickets are generated, the students will be able to give the exams, and the results for the same will be generated by the exam cell. The last module is regarding the reports. Based on the results generated and the available data, sometimes there is a need to interpret data and thereby summarize on the basis of certain parameters. This can be achieved by collecting data in the form of reports using reporting tools. This can be helpful in deriving conclusions on certain events. Next slide, please. The existing systems. There are many colleges who have their own dedicated web portals as well as applications to carry out the examination process. Below are the snippets of such existing systems which we have referred to. The system on the right is of IIT Guwahati, and that on the left is of Deccan Education Society. So our idea is to develop such a system for our college. As we all can see, there is a login page available to enter the credentials for user authentication. Once the user is authenticated, he or she can then view the dashboard and the activities the user can perform. The image of the dashboard is as shown. The activities which the user can perform are also displayed on the snippet in the middle, like view my courses, course registration, and so on. This is a student login, so we are able to view only the things that are accessible to the student as a user. The access of various fields is decided on the basis of bifurcation of the user's category into three types, that is student, faculty, and the exam cell. So based on the category of the user, the permissions are granted, which we will be discussing more in the system architecture. To bring into the note, I would like to say that most of the existing systems are on the web portal, which may create a very slight chance of security being compromised from outside and may have a chance of getting data leaked, which can be used for several unethical purposes. Next slide, please. The next slide, which we are able to view, is regarding the system architecture. The architecture as displayed on the screen consists of users and database. A user interacts with the user interface of the application and fills his or her credentials. After authentication form from the DB, the users are categorized into three types. The first category comprises of students. The second category is of the faculty fraternity. The third category is of the examination cell. The groups are categorized as per their rights and views to access the system. The role and the access specs of the system for every group is as below. Category one of the users, that is students, will be able to register for the courses allotted to them for the respective year of the study as specified by the exam cell. Students can also view their details on the dashboard, as well as they can also check the results once the result is generated by the exam cell. The second category holds the faculty of the college, who can view the results and progress of the students in the respective courses allotted to them. Once the examination is conducted, the faculty can then enter the marks obtained by the students for the respective subjects. Group three comprises of the examination cell, who has a right to allot the courses to the respective departments and the classes. Exam cell also performs the task of generating an exam form so as to collect the details of the students appearing for the examination. Once the data is collected, the next task of the exam cell is to generate the hall ticket for the students. Once the hall ticket is generated, the exam could be conducted on the current examination platform of the college, that is the Moodle platform. After the exams, the exam cell then collects the data of the marks of the students and declares the results for the students, and also derives certain reports in the printable format using some of the reporting tools. Now for the further presentation, I would like to call upon Amit.
Thank you, Madhuri. Now we'll get into the research paper analysis part, which explains why we have chosen Java as our main language and why we have decided to make an application in this language. The first point is Java programs can generally be executed without the fear that the program will accidentally or maliciously damage a host computer, which is very important, such as a web portal has many insecurities which can be exploited by a trained technician. The second point is it is designed to allow developers to create programs quickly and easily without having to deal with many of the low level details of the program, which is very useful for a quick and efficient use cases. The third point is Java is well suited for internet based applications. That makes it one of the few languages which is very flexible and user friendly. And also Java has more options to create a user friendly graphic user interface. All Java programs are run through Java virtual machine, so regardless what device or desktop you are on, it works as it should without any problems. The virtual machine also provides a level of security between programs and host computers, which attracts a lot of developers and users alike. And also, Java comes with a great deal of packages and utilities to make development faster and easier. Due to all of these advantages, we have chosen Java as our main language for this project. Next slide. This is the last slide, which contains the technology stack which we have mutually agreed upon that will be used for the development of this software/application. The first is our language selection, which is Java, which is for the application, and SQL, which is to help us manage the database of students. And the database is in question is MySQL, which is one of the most widely used and free applications to manage databases. And the platform which we have selected is desktop PC. The software which we are going to use is Apache NetBeans IDE. Duties of features that support the development of all Java application types like Java ME, Web, EGB, and also mobile applications out of the box, along with several more features. And MySQL Workbench to manage our MySQL server. Thank you.
I'm highly delighted that many of the teams are working for the examination system. Since we are going into autonomy, these become very crucial. The examination system becomes very crucial. And if we could develop a particular product finally by contribution from all these 3 to 4 teams that are interested in developing the examination system, it would be really useful. Now, what I have seen in a short period of time, you have done a lot of learning about the examination system. So you have to share it among yourselves, sit with your guides, and divide your work into modules, because I think all the modules working for your mini project in this short period of time would not be possible. So you sit together and you take a particular decision, okay, about how you are going to develop. And if we have a semi product which is developed, then we can refine on it in the coming semesters, okay, by all of you working into it. Fine. I hope this idea was good, okay, and will be accepted by all of you.
Yeah, I have one suggestion for team number 2. So Naik sir, yeah. Since we are collecting data of every faculty every semester and at the time of every ranking and so on, so it's better to develop one more additional product like collecting the data of research publications, consultancy awards and so on, which will be helpful for our institute only.
Yeah, the faculty dashboard. Yes.
Why I don't want to invest 3 groups on the same platform, because if by some reason, if we fail to develop such system, we will not fail, of course, but still it will be the what you can decide with the 3 teams, human resources we are utilizing. And then if we are not getting the product, it will not be good for us. So it's better if they will develop the system, and this will be definitely be fruitful product because it's a database project only. And I can tell them also, and we can discuss on Monday what can be the frames or what can be the forms and so on, and what the fields are required, which will be most required thing currently in the institute, gathering of the data. So we will concentrate only on faculty currently, and then we can extend it for the other types of data.
Yes, I agree with what madam has said, because for my group, we have just come up with novelty. Actually, we did not have a discussion as everyone was differently located. So even I would be interested in doing one of the, in fact, my teams also. So it's really nice initiative. So we'll discuss it on Monday amongst us as project guides.
Okay.
Any questions for our group?
No, you can continue.
Yes. So the next team, team number 5, Yash Kasliwal's team, presenter is Ankit Morde, under the guidance of Dr. L.M. R.J. Lobo, sir. Ankit, you can continue.
Hello. We are team number 5, and we are going to make an entity system for all the treasury and all the confidential things. So these are our team members, and our guide is Dr. L.M. R.J. Lobo. So we'll continue. So our main objective of our project is to make a device to catch the intruder through laser beam technology. So in this project, we are going to make a laser beam technology for the treasure. Then usually after a theft undergo a lot of loss, so this can prevent that loss. In this system, whenever a thief gets a laser light, it will trigger an alarm or buzzer sound, or it will give a notification on your phone, and which will warn you, and you can avoid your loss. So the main abstract of our project is a laser-based anti-theft. It's a type of security and alarm system that uses laser light and a light sensor. A security system protects our homes, offices, banks, lockers, etc. from intrusion and unauthorized access. There are different types of security systems available, and laser-based security system is also an important and efficient type. A laser security system can act as a standalone system, which makes some sound or noise, and it detects an irregular activity, even an air or any animal or an insect. Or it can be a much part of bigger security and home automation system, which can send message or call the owner, and so on. So these are the hardware and software in hardware. To use Raspberry Pi 4 model B, a breadboard, one UF capacitor, a light dependent resistor, female male jumpers for testing, female to female jumper leads, a laser pointer. And we are going to do this project in Raspbian OS, which is specially for Raspberry Pi, and we are going to use a Python as our main language and a few commands for running as a standalone assistant. So the expected results of our project are laser security system can be used in safety lockers and in our homes, where even the locker code is hacked, it acts as an additional layer of security. For example, if you are doing and you want to protect something, you can use technology to prevent thefts. And we are specially making this technology, as this technology is too costly or expensive. We are making it in the cheapest rate. So it is very useful for today's generation. Apart from any security system, this laser based can set up also be used to check if pets or babies cross a certain boundary. Yes, this can also be used because most of the owners of dogs don't pay attention to the dogs, and they want to know if dog or cat has passed the boundary of their house. And through this technology, we can detect them and we can avoid such misunderstandings. Okay, so thank you everyone. This is about our project.
Okay, thank you, Yash.
At what height this will be?
Any
depends.
How many laser lights we are going to put? First of all,
because based on the heights, many next question comes over.
Based on height,
ma'am, like if we are installing this inside a locker, there will be a standard height, like in the middle or using diagonally.
No, how you are having the pattern, I don't understand, because somebody may go below that particular laser beam if you are having it at the middle of the
wall. Yes, it depends on us. Ma'am, how many laser beam we are going to apply? For example,
that you have to think. No, if it is inside, there are different questions. If it is outside the house, so if bird will cross that particular beam or something like that, then what will happen? And if it is too high, then anybody can go below that laser and can. So you have to make a pattern such that at any height, nobody will disturb this or cross that.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. We'll work on that.
Yeah, and if, whether it is a human entity or the other entities, that how you are going to identify, that I don't know.
What ones?
Whether it is whether that particular is a human entity or the other entity who is crossing that laser beam, how you will identify?
Anything, it will identify anything, even an insect.
No, but see, so every time, see, at in the midnight, if anyone is crossing, that is the bird or animal, then every time it will be go on flashing light, no? That there
so
is.
So, ma'am, if we are using this to surround the house, will you really have a fencing before, before the laser system? So, a bird or an animal can't enter that fencing, no?
Okay, so currently, are you going to develop a prototype or a product like that, a model?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We are going to make the model.
For outside or inside?
Ma'am, both.
First of all, we will try inside, and then afterwards, so if it gets successful, we'll try outside. We'll try both.
Have you thought about the budget?
Ma'am, budget only around about 5,000, ma'am.
No, no, don't tell it haphazardly. You have to think on it. So think on it.
No, ma'am, for Raspberry Pi cost around about 4,000, and all the products that I have, we have used in hardware, it costs around 200 to 300 rupees.
And what about that laser cross pattern that you are going to
create? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Everything is 200 rupees.
200. I've made an estimation, ma'am.
Because this is already existing, so do survey and how you can do it better, that you have to think. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. This is a existing project, but we are trying to make it as cheap as possible.
Yeah, so you have to think on square meter pattern like that.
Yes, ma'am.
This is 5,000. You're talking about a model which you're going to develop and see if what will happen if it is the room of this much size, if this is the house of that much size, and you have to think accordingly, no?
Okay, ma'am.
So whatever the model that you are taking, you have to take the dimension, and the cost will be as per the dimensions.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
Got it.
Fine.
Thank you.
Anybody has any question? Or shall I continue with the next thing? So, next team, that is team number 6, Tejasri Margam's team, and presenters are Anisha Ashtikar and Mansi Khawasi, under the guidance of Professor A.S. Naik sir. Anisha and Mansi.
Hello. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Shall I start?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. Respected HOD sir, teachers, and all my friends. First, let me introduce myself. I am Mansi Khawasi.
And I am Anisha Ashtikar.
Our team leader is Tejasri Margam, and our co-leaders are Vishaka Kale and Shirisha Rapeli. We are working under the guidance of Nayak sir. I would like to give you a brief breakdown of our mini project, that is Plasma Donation Management System. The purpose of this project is to help out the people who are in search for plasma donor, as we have the facility of searching nearby donors, and also acceptor can easily find out and contact the donors in immediate response. Now, moving to our objective, our main constraint is to design and develop a web application to generate plasma donation management system. So now let us talk about some key points that is our solution to motivate the society and also spread the awareness about plasma donation. Next, this platform is designed to help out the plasma receivers to find the plasma donors, same as plasma donors who are eligible and interested to donate can approach. The user has to create the account for accessing. Now, coming to the most important point, we have a feature which helps receiver to find a nearby donor and contact through the details provided in the profile. We will be maintaining the records of the plasma donors, whether they were actively participating. If there is no immediate response, then the account will be auto deactivated. An online e-certificate will be provided to the donors. Now, moving to our next slide, that is existing system. There is no awareness among society about donation. People have zero knowledge about pros and cons of plasma donation. It was observed that lot of misguidance was done regarding plasma therapy. People rarely donate plasma into blood banks, hospitals. It is also found that people only donate to the dear ones. Due to this, there is lack of plasma available. Now, I would like to hand it over to Anisha.
Thank you, Mansi. So let me start with some general information on plasma donation. As you are all aware, in this pandemic period, to fight against the epidemic disease, one of the methods called as plasma therapy is used. So we are going to prepare a web application development to help the people for donating and accepting the plasma who has already been recovered from COVID and are eligible for donating plasma. I would like to illustrate this point by showing the system architecture. Now here, as the web interface has been divided into two parts, that is donor and receiver. This donor and receiver has some modules. First, individual can register for donor as well as receiver as per their status. Donor who satisfy all the eligibility criteria will only be allowed to register. The receiver can search donor through its location and can contact them as mentioned earlier. In the plasma collection section, all the records of donor and receiver are mentioned regarding till the date of survey, when they have donated or received, then the eligibility criteria of the donors, etc. In FAQ column, all the feedbacks records are being mentioned. In this data, all this data is being stored in the database. Moving to the next part of the database, we have two columns. In our first column, we have plasma bank inventory, where all the entries will be saved. And in the plasma inventory API, where all the entries will be updated. In the next column, we have UID verification, where all the consent or valid data will be verified. And in the UID inventory, we will be saving the unique data entries. This part will be act as the backend of the database. Now, moving towards the last slide, which is technology stack. Next slide. So here, we are going to use the language, which will be HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Bootstrap, and PHP or Python. Following with that, a Sublime Text Editor or Spider for the software, storage of database by PLSQL, and the main platform will be the browser. Well, that's about it for this part. Coming towards the references, we have collected all the information from various resources like search engine. We have been explored many websites as Midlife, SciTech, IEEE Explorer, and various articles, etc. And also some parts through the news and reports as Times of India and Hindustan Times. Regarding with this, and online surfing on social media as Instagram and Twitter. Now that's bring me to the end of our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Anisha and Mansi both.
Okay, Anisha, I'm asking one question.
before plasma donation, is there any mandatory test should be carried out by patient, by donor, before donating the plasma?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, so sir. Patient. Yes, sorry.
You are mentioning your system or what type of, how the patient will get information, means what type of test he or she should carry out?
Sir, the blood group is mandatory. They should specify their blood group. When the blood group matches, then the acceptor will approach the donor.
Okay.
And also, sir, there will be an eligibility criteria about what the age will be and at how many days that person will be active for donating the plasma.
Okay. And sir,
is there an age limit? Age limit is there or what?
Yes, sir. There is age limit.
The age limit is up to 18 to 55.
18 to 55. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Anyone has any question?
I think Gajbar sir has some questions. So, Gajbar sir, if you have any questions, you can unmute and ask.
I wanted to ask for the previous project group.
You okay. Can ask now. It's valid. You can please go ahead and ask the question.
No problem. I will ask. No, I was I wanted to ask question about the Lobosar's project. Yes. So in that case, he was using LDR in that case. So in that case, LDR is not a very practical thing to use with the laser, because LDR sensitivity is not very much accurate. So for example, when I used LDR in my project way back in 5 years or 10 years back, in that case, for to have the sensitivity, you have to actually close that LDR by hand. Okay, so that was my question. So I wanted to give him a suggestion that instead of LDR, he should try to have some other alternative for LDR rather than using LDR.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We will.
So check for other alternative for the LDR. Okay.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, Gajbar sir. We'll definitely take note of this.
Yes, sir.
Good morning to one and all. I welcome you to our presentation on Fit India application. I am Yash Sakkargi, will be presenting today along with my fellow team members Abhijit Mai, Sanskar Raut, Pranav Suryavanshi and Rohan Sir Deshmukh, and we are guided by our Professor Katwati sir. In the upcoming days we are going to work on developing this app. The health and fitness has been a main priority of everybody from the beginning. Now, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the urge of fitness and proper nutrition is at its peak, rather than it is the need of the hour. So our team is going to develop an app that satisfies these needs. The COVID-19 induced lockdown on nutrition has a very diverse effect on our nutrition, health and lifestyle patterns. Without balanced nutrition, our body is more prone to disease, infection, fatigue and low performance. So the main purpose of our application is to increase the fitness and metabolic health and incur healthy eating habits for the clients or the users. What is the scope? Moving on to the scope, our project will deliver a flexible range of cell phone diet plans. The user can create his own diets. We are going to provide him our diets for weighing, and the user will be also able to get better understanding of his meals and track his calories. The main objective of this project is to create a healthy environment and design and develop an application so that the user can create his own diet charts and gain or lose weights according to the client's needs. Moving on to the existing systems, we have studied the existing systems. We have studied the existing systems.
Hello.
Like automation.
Hello. Yes. Can you share a screen? It is not visible.
It is visible, sir.
Okay. Okay. Yes, it is.
We have studied the existing systems. The existing systems have complicated UIs. They need too much of input from the user, and they lack automation. We are going to work on these points to make our app more user friendly, and so that it is easy to use. User can manually add fitness routines. We will provide proper nutritional information. Less data input will be required in our app. The structure architecture of this app will be: the client will download the application. Where on first running the application, he will be login and sign up page will be rendered. The new users will sign up and the old users will log in using their email and ID, email ID, mobile number or password. The second page, the second activity, they will be physical profile. They will the user will be able to add his height and weight along with his gender and age. The data added by the user will be collected in our database and will be used to create BMI of BMI and BMR, the basic mass index, body mass index of the user. And on calculating the BMI, the user will be given a pop-up message about advice about if he's overweight or underweight, and what calorie consumption he needs to do in a day. Further moving on to the basic input, the user will be given he will be free to put the basic availability of his food in his nearby area, so that we can give him a proper diet chart that is easily available from him. And the user can also be will also get a weekly data update on his app. Conclusion: the proposed system will cope up with the existing data drawbacks. It will also give us the statistical analysis of nutritional values in his user's meal. The project will give us a user-friendly application that satisfies his needs, and the clients and more people will become conscious about their diets and fitness goals. Project provides a wide scope of diet and healthy lifestyle. And additional features to this is we can add nutritional tips. The user can customize his diets. We can also add recipe lists, and for a gym user, for various gyms, they need add nutrition along with work exercise. They also need proper nutrition. So along with in collaboration,
yes. Yes, sorry for disturbing you. Time has finished. You can conclude yourself.
Yes. So we are going to develop this app using Java language on Android Studio. The database will include SQLite, and platform will be Android. References, we have the references, various magazines such as Shape and Eating Well Fitness. We have taken the references. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Yash.
Yash, are you going to provide certificate to the users, Fit India's fitness certificate?
Yes, sir. The certificate, no, it is a basic body health management system. It is not going to be the user will also get badges that they can share. on social media for their achievements. As if a user has gained weight, if he wants to get and he has gained weight, he will get his certification badge that he can share or this.
So if he or she get the badge, then how particular time it, the validity of that particular badge?
So we can give that badge as if in points. If the user will log in daily and refer the diets, he will automatically get some points, and we can provide him some additional personal diet plans on that badges.
Okay.
Okay, anybody has any question?
ठीक है प्रथमेश कंटिन्यू
ओके सर ओके सो द नेक्स्ट टीम नंबर 9 इशिता सदारिया
बिफोर यू स्टार्ट आई वुड लाइक यश वेरी वेल प्रेजेंटेड एंड इट इज गुड टू सी दैट यू हैव रियली प्रेजेंटेड वेरी वेल सो कीप इट अप यश एंड योर टीम ओके
सो द नेक्स्ट टीम नंबर 9 इशिता सदारिया टीम प्रेजेंटर इशिता इटसेल्फ एंड अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर एल एम आर्जु लोबो सर Ishita, you can continue.
Okay. So, is my screen visible?
No, not yet.
One second. So, is it visible now?
Yes, now it is visible.
Okay. So, good morning, everybody. So, myself, Ishita Sadaria. And on my behalf of the team, I am a presenter on my project that is online health consultant, or we can say as an online dietitian. So the main objective is to design and develop an online web application or monitoring a day-to-day health meter. So without wasting time moving forward, so the solution we will, the web application we will be providing is firstly, it will be calculating the BMI, that is body mass index. So weight loss or weight gain, depending upon the user's needs, special dietitian information on the special regards, on the time limit, the diet plan according to the workout or the exercise which the user is going to do, and or you can say that last is regular diet plan. Okay, so existing system is that the people nowadays are becoming very health conscious, so they are visiting the doctors, and nowadays the obesity problem has been increased due to the lack of activity, outdoor activity, and virtual work nowadays has been increased, so the activities has been decreased. And due to the COVID situation, the immunity is also the most important factor, because nowadays you are not getting the immunity, especially from the sunlight, which is the source of vitamin D. And in the existing system, the high medication fees, which is also not affordable by the everyone. So these are some existing factors which the people or the user can facing it. So this is our small system architecture. In this, the user will be logged in through the web browser according to its convenience from any place through the internet. And the web application, it's basically a module of e-clinic portal that is, you can say, as an online hospital instead of going to the main hospital. And the data base and all the information regarding the clients or the users information will be stored at the database server, that is MySQL. So system requirements, we will be used for the software requirement. We will be using Windows 7, we can to the 10. So SQL is database technology. We will be going to is the web development. And hardware requirements are implies of permanence and invariability, and for a project you can use on it might be laptop or the personal computer consisting of any operating system, might be Mac OS, Windows or the Linux systems.
And so the outcomes of these our project is that it can depending you can protect yourself against the diseases, that is by preparing the proper flow chart of your diet, or you can say or the balanced diet, reduces the inflammation, controls high cholesterol. Nowadays we are addicted to the junk food, which is the main factor which is of the developing the cholesterol. It also helps in the weight loss, those who have an obesity problem, and increase the metabolism. Nutrition is one of the important factor, because nowadays nutrition is which helps to fight against the COVID disease also. A better sound sleep is also a important factor to be a healthy, because if you don't get better sleep, you your next day would be like feel lazy and all. So boost your immune system. Immune system is also important, because if it's strong, then you can fight against all the diseases. So conclusion I would like to add is that the software reduces the time span and the cost for the expert advice is that the high bills the when you visit to the doctor, that you won't pay here. Good nutritional habits with a balanced diet from the early age, because nowadays at the low age many diseases are being confined to the body. The nutrition system is available all the time and can be used in any places. So this is the system from that you can access from anywhere, any place and any time. So some of the references, and we are the team members, Ishita, Divya, Surbi, Pujita, Nagalakshman, Maheshwari, which we have helped all the back end. And so I want to thank our projects, which was guided by our Lobo sir. So thank you, sir, at all the time for the important guidance which you have given.
And thank you, Ishita. Your time is finished. Okay. Questions.
How your system will be different than the Yash system, previous system that we have discussed?
Ma'am, it will be it was coincidentally same. So we will try to keep the different things, which especially in the user's need, we will be using artificial intelligence. We can use online chat bot. So according to what the user wants, the questions, they will be replied, and to their expected answers, most expected answer they would get.
So chatbot, right now you are adding a feature or you have already thought about it?
No, ma'am, we had already a thought about it. So
we will have a presentation of both the teams again at the end. It should not be the same application.
Yeah, ma'am, we will
try. Be different. So you discuss with Yash group also.
Yes, I guess there is one more project which is on the same lines, nutrition and health. It's about fruits and something. So let's see whether they are finalized with the same. I don't know right now. Okay, carry on.
Okay, ma'am, we will try to be different than the other teams. So it doesn't match all the same qualities which we
see, have. All of you remember one thing, that your product or your development should be used by someone. Okay, it should be a usable application, then only it will be your credit. Otherwise, it's not only that we are to develop one project and get 25 marks or get marks out of 25. It's not our objective at all. Okay, so it's an appeal to all the groups that you have to develop an application which will be used by end user. So if you have anyone who is consultant, who is dietitian, the one who know it, and the person will use your system, then you meet that person, you ask the requirement again. If any changes there, do make changes and then accordingly work. And same is the case with the others also. So meet end user, see the requirements, do the analysis, and then develop the application.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
So that you can deploy that application.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
You can also contact people from industry, okay, who will give you some very good inputs. Okay, so
yes, sir,
in this line, you Yeah, you can ask them for a sponsorship if they are ready for it. Otherwise, just take their technical advice at least. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, shall I continue with the next team?
Or anybody? Yes, please.
Okay, sir. So the next team, team number 10, Srinandini Beth's team, and the presenter is Srinandini and Shruti Siddhapurmad, under the guidance of Dr. S.S. Gajbhar, sir. Okay, Srinandini and Shruti, you can continue.
Thank you, Prathamesh. Good morning, all. Good morning, sir, and good morning, ma'am. Myself, Shruti Siddhapur Mad, and my team members are Srinandini Beth and Shweta Savan. Here, we are going to present a short presentation on our Android application, which is named as Food Recipe. We are going to develop a mobile app. When you are having a bad day, science says you shouldn't automatically collapse on a couch. It might be better idea to work out with the recipe book. The emotional benefits of cooking are countless. It's something you can replicate in your own home with bit of efforts and the ingredients. Our objective of our project is to design and develop a mobile application to generate a digital recipe book. Our application provides different kind of food recipes, which we can search from our template and fetch from the API. We can browse the recipes from different kinds of meal and the diet type. Our application will also work with the both remote as well as local data sources. Our application also establishes a connection between our app and the server. Send a GET request to our API and receive a list of food recipes as a response. Our application also handles a no internet connection and store or cache the data locally to our database. Next slide, please. We need a food recipe app instead of recipe book because in book, recipes are written manually and after some time, book may get damaged or get misplaced. Also, the searching of recipe in our book may take a longer time and it may happen you don't have the recipe in that book for which you are searching for a long time. So, you need a recipe app for easy to search and faster to use. I would like to call Srinandini for further presentation.
Thank you, Shruti. So nowadays there is an increasing demand for these kinds of applications. And that is confirmed by statistics. And as latest research claims that the cooking and recipe app market has reached more than $2.15 million and has already attracted many users. So now to get the basic idea of how the app works, here is a system architecture. So basically we are going to develop an app that is going to be used by user. And there are two databases, that is local and remote databases. So the first, when user want to access any recipe, then first it goes to our local database. And if the recipe is there, then it is given back to the user. And if there is no recipe found in our local database, then we are going to use an API. That is based on the remote database. So from there, the user can get requests. And this is in the case of internet connection. Suppose if there is no internet connection available on the user side, then too it can access the recipes that are stored in the local database. And if there is no recipe stored in the local database, then there a message is displayed. Next slide, please. So as we are going to develop an app, we are going to use the language Kotlin on the back end and extensible markup language, that is XML, in the front end. And we are going to develop it in Android Studio. And on the back end, we are also going to use SQLite. And these are the references which we have used. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Shruti and Srinandini.
Moving on. Okay. I have some questions. Can you go to the first slide? Shruti?
Yes, ma'am.
So the app is primarily for, can you just go to the first slide?
Shweta.
Yes, ma'am.
So how is it different? How is it different from the like, what is the advantage of this and what is the novelty of it?
Actually, it's going to provide all different kinds of recipes. So according to user, he can search. For example, we are also going to keep meals and diet tabs that include like breakfast, lunch, dinner. So according to his requirement, he can search, and also the diet types. For example, like vegan, Italian, and there are many more kinds through which he can.
Right. Oh, what I want to say, you are saying about the keto diet, you are talking about intermittent fasting. I can understand that. But if I just type one word on Google, intermittent dieting chat, everything I get, like YouTube, everything I get, the diet, how to make it, and it's more engaging. So in one, just I type the keyword, okay, I get the engaging videos, what has to be eaten, what has not, what to be eaten, which type of diet, if it is keto or if it is gluten free or if it is something like that. So how is that different? Like, I'm getting the same data on YouTube, right, along with the procedures to make it.
No, I will answer this. It's not always about the novelty, because they are currently in third year and they are learning a lot of technical subjects. For example, they are learning MAD subject right now. So my intention was for allowing them to take this subject was to have some end-to-end project where they can practice all the technical things which they have learned in the subject.
Yes.
Because what happens in the, although there are some laboratories available for particular subject, for example, MAD, those will not give the actual, what can I say, practical knowledge to them. So when they take such kind of application where they have end-to-end, so they have to thought about starting from designing each and every bit of their project to the complete finalization of project. So it just don't see in the perspective of novelty. I see it in the perspective of implementation of all the knowledge which they have gained in particular subject.
Yes, sir, that is okay. Means I don't have, with respect to technology, Android application learning, it is fine.
But since it is a mini project, I would have completely agreed with your point if it would have been a BE project. But since it is a mini project and we do not want to extend it for the final year project, we thought that we should take a subject which will allow them to implement all of their knowledge which they are learning from their current subjects. Like here they can implement their database concept, here they can implement Kotlin, etc. So I will make sure that they implement on their own. They should not copy the code from anywhere else. Okay, that I will take as part of my guarantee.
Yes. That
both
is
sir and madam, I would like to now intervene in between. Okay, yeah. Both the ideas are very good. Okay, what the guide is thinking and what Ausika madam also is talking about. Let the student, when they have time, do an analysis of what is already available, okay, and what they are doing. So if they find out that particular gap, okay, and that particular gap they are proposing also some novelty into it, okay, that can be treated as a future scope, okay. So let them do something so that they know, then they get a good experience of doing such things in their major project. Is it clear, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So I agree with the madam's point also. I no problem with that.
Yes.
But sometimes we have to think about implementation of knowledge. So my perspective was that point. Since it is a mini project.
It's okay. Yeah. That is correct. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Can we go to the next project?
Okay, sir. So the next team number 11, Vinay Oswal's team. Presenter is Vinay Oswal itself, and under the guidance of Professor S.K. Karpe ma'am. Vinay?
Is the screen visible?
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. I am Vinay Oswal, and today I am going to represent our idea. So I begin with the presentation now. Our group consists of 5 members, Prasad Setwal, Nitin Jain, Chintan Jain, Adish Paratwal, and myself. We are going to develop an e-commerce website by using the web application development technology.
Shruti, mute yourself, please.
Vinay, you have to do the slideshow.
So I begin with the presentation now. Our group consists of 5 members, Prasad Setwal, Nitin Jain, Chintan Jain, Adish Paratwal, and myself. We are
Vinay, sorry to interrupt you. You can start your presentation from first slide, that is slideshow. From beginning, here.
Okay, wait.
Your slides are only visible.
We are going
at the left corner. At the left corner, you have a button from beginning. Click there.
It is also okay now.
We are basically going to develop an e-commerce website by using the web application development technology. Our objective is to design and develop a web application to provide online grocery shopping solution to consumers and vendors. Our motive is to provide solution to user, rich user experience, advanced product search, convenient product comparison, smooth order management, and last is customer analytics. Now, the existing system, we all know that if grocery store is a retail store that primary sells good, grocery store managers must ensure the store runs smoothly, that items are priced comparatively, and that customers are satisfied. Grocery store
Vinay, hold on. You are not making a slideshow and you are not moving to the next slide. So first do the slideshow so that you can move to the next slide. Yeah.
No.
Okay. Yeah, that's right.
So, grocery store managers must ensure that the store runs smoothly, that items are priced comparatively, and that consumers are satisfied. Grocery store often sell food items and various household goods. The concept of general store is old, and although some still exist. We all know that the existing system consists of shop or supermarket where the user needs or the customer needs to physically go and buy the desired goods. But there are some disadvantages. In case of big supermarkets and big stores, the existing system is computerized to some extent, but it is not fully automated to cover all the aspects of the supermarket. Talking about the current situation, we all know that in grocery store, a huge crowd there. Wherever we are going to buy anything which consumes our most time, also the whole world is suffering from the global pandemic. Crowd is one of the reasons behind rising cases of COVID-19. To overcome this, we have to focus on the solution. Shifting towards online platform is convenient for both shop owner and the customers. Now, system architecture. There are total 2 diagrams. So first, I can explain one. So here, the shop owner or the administrator have access to add category, add subcategory, add items. And he can view the profile of the customers. So the customer have right or access to the order items. He can make payments online. He have access to change password, log out, and he can view the items and search items whatever he wants. Also, if in big supermarkets, we all know that the supermarket owner or the administrator can't do all the things. So his employee or the staff can also access the that is view profiles. If customer wants to change password, then employees can do that thing. So here we can see clearly that admin or the shop owner has access to the add category, subcategory, add items, view profile. Now employee have the access to the view profile, change password, logout, and customer having the access to the view items, order he can order the items, view profile and wallet, that he can make the payments online. Now the proposed system aims at the full automation of the big and medium mini grocery store or supermarket by making the system reliable and fast, user friendly and informative. It reduces paperwork requirement and increases the productivity the existing system. Now technology stack, here we use the HTML, CSS, JavaScript and Python. Software, here we are using that Visual Studio. Database, MySQL. Platform, it can be accessible on the browser. And algorithm, data mining. Dependency, it completely depends on the client requirements, what clients need. Here we take the references of igret.org, which is the basically a research paper, and the grocery store, supermarkets, it's also a research paper. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinay.
Are you going to build this for a particular customer? You have customer in
No, miss. Actually, we are building just for as a currently we are not having any customers. But if as we are talk with the Karpe ma'am, they said that find the that sponsors or whatever the customers to building this site client.
Yeah, because this is with if customized apps are available like DMart or other malls, they are already having these particular services, isn't it?
Yes, miss, but actually at the local levels, means it, I am from Sangli, that some big shops are there which needs the compete with the DMart and the JioMart, so they have to do the same thing with their customers on online platform.
Yeah, the particular customer will the seller will have this app, but what about the end users?
Okay, because, so
yeah.
Miss, see, the grocery store, they have the customers, fixed, some of the fixed customers, so they can tell them to buy through the website, so it saves their time. So
it's very, very, that it's the true thing that it is saving the time and so on. But see, this is again the previous discussion regarding the novelty and feasibility. We want the feasible solutions and we want some novelty also. So if you can find any customer for this particular project, it will be the added thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, anyone has any question? Okay, so moving towards team number 12. Team number 12, Rushabh Belokar's team. Presenters are Sonal Katkar and Rituja Paratwar, under the guidance of Professor B.B. Shaharkar sir. Sonal and Rituja, continue.
Thank you, Prathamesh. Good morning, everyone. My name is Sonal and we are team number 12, and our team members are Harish, Rituja, Prachi and Rushabh. So basically we are going to develop a website for Vishwakarma Katkar Engineering Udyog. As we all know, the benefits of website, it basically depends on online presence, means customer are always able to find you, and information exchange, it cuts the cost of traveling. It saves the time, and it is always helpful for advertisement of your products, and it avoids the physical contact, means customer don't need to present at the place physically. They can view on online websites. So basically, customer first will visit the website and then they will search for the product. Customer can log in through their registered ID, or they can log in as guest to view the products. and we are going to provide the various options for customer to book machine, to ask questions related to machine, and they can also write the queries. This is the system architecture. Also, customer has various payment options like cash on delivery, Google Pay, Phone Pay, bank transfer, and other online payment sources or apps. But customer has to do first advance booking. Customer will receive transaction acknowledgement through mail or text on mobile. Also, customer can add address for delivery of the product. This is the overall design of our project. Like this, customer can go through the process. And the language, software, database, platform, algorithm, all technology stack we are going to use is as follows. The language we are going to use is HTML, CSS, JavaScript. And the software we are going to use is VS Code and Live Server. And database is MySQL. And the platform we are going to use is web design, and algorithm is data mining. So basically, we are going to develop the website for workshop. And here, dependency of our project or website is on completely on client requirement. And this is the reference. We are going to display like our paper research.
Thank you, Sonal.
Yes.
Okay. The time is finished.
Thank you.
Moving towards questions.
Okay, what do you mean by the algorithm data mining? That was a question to previous group also. What are you going to do that with that algorithm data mining? If it is a website that you're going to develop for a customer.
Ma'am, like we are going to gather the information that customer has. Means if customer has any query related machines or they have previously have machine and they have any query, then we are going to gather that all data. And
for whom you are developing this system?
Sorry, ma'am.
Who is your customer?
Ma'am, we are developing website for workshop. The customers,
workshop.
We have products. Yes, ma'am. We have products like Atta Chakki, sugar cane juice machine, and mixers, gravy machine. So we are going to display the
selling or what it is for maintenance or what it is workshop. I don't understand why workshop.
Ma'am, we have machines like Atta Chakki, box Chakki. And we are going to display the images, pictures, videos of our machines. So customer can search, like if we want Atta Chakki for our home or for a business purpose, then customer search regarding these products.
Okay, actually the company is selling these products.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, you have to discuss with your guide also. Data mining is not an algorithm, but data mining is a field which supports large amount of algorithms, and they may be classification, clustering, or association rule mining algorithm. Which specific algorithm you are going to use, this little bit analysis you have to do, okay, before using it into your project, okay? So this is a blunder by writing an algorithm data mining. Okay, you could write some algorithms from data mining, something like that way. Because data mining itself is not an algorithm. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
That in mind and work upon that. Okay. It's good that you're going into a recent emerging technology like data mining, but try to understand about that particular technology a little bit more in detail. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, anyone has any more question? Okay, so the next team is team number 13. Is team number 13 is present currently?
Who is that team?
Krishna's team, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Pratham, they have not reported to me right now. त्यांनी रिपोर्ट केलेलं नाही.
नेक्स्ट टीम,
इफ दे आर नॉट रिपोर्टिंग, टेक द नेक्स्ट टीम.
ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट टीम, टीम नंबर 14, शिवानी कुलकर्णी टीम. प्रेझेंटर शिवानी कुलकर्णी अँड सेलिना कोटा अंडर द गायडन्स ऑफ मिसेस मिस डी डी औसेकर.
हॅलो,
येस शिवानी, यू कॅन कंटिन्यू.
इज इट विजिबल?
येस इट इज.
I'm Shivani Kulkarni. We are project group 14. And I have observed that whenever we need some book about some information, we have to search a lot on Google first, and later in after going to library, we just flip through pages of so many books to find the book we really want when we don't know the name or author of the book. So the objective of our group is to design and develop a web-based book recommendation engine by combining collaborative filtering and context-based results. So the solution is user can choose from two different filtering options, make books predictions using context-based filtering to recommend books using content information, and recommend book items to user based on most similar users, that means ratings and feedback of other users. Other features in this would be a user can search using author, publisher, etc., just like the old system. Provide auto search complete. Users can rate books, add tags, and provide feedbacks. So the existing system is like we go to the library first, then spend time on searching for book with information we want. When we don't know about what particular, in what particular book we will get the information. Otherwise, we go on Google and search by similar names and then scroll through long list of books and reads their description to find the appropriate one. So we cannot predict books according to given context or information requirement. And we have to search or flip through pages of many books to find the useful ones. And other recommendation applications are there, and that uses only user ratings and are popularity based and not content based. So the system architecture for our book recommendation engine would be it's a web application. So there are two options in that. We can choose either context-based engine, that means the content we want to search, based on that it will predict the books. Otherwise, user collaborative filtering, that means it calculates similar users based on ratings and feedbacks and their past history and matches with their interests. So use of that and future scope will be, we can use this system in libraries by replacing the old search systems or manually finding the books. We can give links or provide sources to get the book. With modification, same system can be used for other recommendation engines also, such as movies, series, and many other. Users can give feedback on books or suggest book names for particular topics. So it would be helpful for later users, so they will, it will be easy for them to find more books according to their feedback. And technology we are going to use in this would be Python language. Database is MySQL database. For a front end, HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap. For back end, Django. And we are going to use data sets for the user ratings and feedbacks from Book Crossing dataset and Amazon book reviews. Dependency would be user requirements, and these are the references we have used for it.
Rani, moving towards questions.
Yeah, go to your slide, Shivani.
Which slide?
Show me the system architecture. Open your system architecture.
This is now.
I think it stopped, no?
Yes, it is not visible. Shivani, you can show it.
Is it visible or no? No, okay.
Not yet.
Okay, wait, 1 minute. Now?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Why this is dangling? Why it is not connected that all four intercalculates?
These are just for explanation. These blue boxes are just for explanation.
No. Then you should not draw it, no, in the architecture. When you are drawing it as an entity, there should be some connection in between that.
These are just for explanation.
And the other part, you are talking about the recommendation system. And what about that machine learning algorithms and all? What do you think? Thought about it, which machine?
I searched about it a bit and I found that KNN algorithm is useful for it, for collaborative filtering purpose.
You need to do a survey on it first for recommendation system.
Okay, ma'am.
I want to use the existing data sets, then why, what is the purpose of taking database separately?
We will take feedbacks from users also. Ratings and feedbacks.
No, but the data set which you are referring will have some other parameters. And the feedback that you are taking will have some other different data. How you are going to match it?
No, ma'am, ratings are ratings from scale 1 to 5, these would be from integer data type or float. Or then feedbacks would be from text.
No, have you checked the data set?
What?
Sorry. Have you checked the data set which you are mentioning here?
I haven't created anything yet.
No, you have mentioned the data set that, go to the last slide.
These are from existing data yes. Set.
Have you checked these data sets?
Yeah, I have checked.
So what are the parameters in it?
They're book ratings, reviews, and users, like that.
How you are going to add this data set, or how you are going to integrate these data sets with your database? If you are not taking the feedback into consideration for recommendation, then what is the use of taking feedback?
It will be helpful for other users. When they recommend book, they will see, when the book gets recommended, they will see the feedbacks also.
Okay. Okay, fine.
Okay, anyone has any question? Okay, moving towards team number 15. Team number 15, Aniket Bedarkar's team. Present are Aniket Bedarkar itself and under the guidance of Professor A.R. Deshpande. Aniket, towards.
Hello. Is it visible?
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you, Prathamesh. Hello, myself Aniket Bedarkar, and I am here to present our topic, that is converting handwritten documents as scanned images or photos to legible text documents. So this has various applications in academic sector, as well as scanning bank checks and scanning postal addresses on the letters. For this, we will provide solution by scanning the image, then forming the segmentation of image in horizontal and vertical directions, and then further fade the gathered data to the neural network for extracting and getting the output. Currently, there are various applications that provide features in this area, but they can convert typed text to text, and that too is a paid application. And few of these applications are not available for every devices. So our approach for this will be, we will get the image, we'll input the image, then pre-process it, that is get line segmentation and word segmentation, and then convert that. The recognition engine will understand and create the letters and words, and further process that words to analyze and get the output. And the way to do it is, we'll get the image, And for text detection, we'll localize the text, then track the next text, and then again localize until the file is ended. And then the text segmentation will happen. That is, we will get the words and lines from the image and recognize the text and get the text as object, a text object. And for this, we'll use Python, HTML, CSS, Java, and software we'll need to do is Notepad, Jupyter, Anaconda, and Java Virtual Machine. And then the platform will be Google Chrome. The algorithm used is multi-layer artificial neural network.
Okay, thank you, Aniket. Question answering session.
Which exact algorithms of ANN you are going to use? You are saying it is multi-layer, okay? But before going to use it or feeding it to a neural network, you require to get some attributes of your particular handwritten characteristics, okay? Those attributes, which are the X's, okay, have to be then weighted. So how are you extracting that X's from your handwritten database? And how are you converting it into a form that can be fed to the neural network? Have you thought about that?
No, sir. I will have to refer for that.
No, yeah. Even whether you're going for some skeletization algorithm, whether you're going for some regional descriptors, whether you're going for some boundary descriptors, okay? Whether you're going to go for the RGB values, all these particular things you have to think about, okay? Then you have to get an estimate, and that estimate will be treated then as your X's, okay? Then you will be weighting all these particular X's, okay? And then you will be feeding it onto your network. What are the two layers in your ANN? You're saying multi-layer means at least two layers should be there. Okay, so which are those two layers have you thought about? So think about all these particular things. Okay.
Sir, I have read about this neighbor classifier, radial basis classifier.
Yes, yes. But you have to be clear about what are these, what is this multi-layer and how you are going to use it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No, you need to check the feasibility also. Can we finish it as a mini project, or are you going to extend it further?
We can extend also, ma'am.
No. Don't say haphazardly. If you want to extend it, then what kind of work that you will be finishing as a mini project, that also you have to think.
We were thinking of making it as a mobile application for future scope.
No. It's a big task to convert an image into text.
Yes,
so if you want to take it as a final year project, then what is the task that you will be finishing as mini project that you have to define today itself? Today itself means okay. As a part of the project itself.
Yes, ma'am. It seems to be a little bit difficult to understand everything now, but we are thinking that we can do it.
Yeah, you discuss with your guide and then think about it.
Yes, ma'am.
And you divide this project into modules. Some of the modules you'll complete as your mini project. Okay. And then you can continue it as your major project. Is it clear? Sir. So yes, make sir. That classification along with your guide.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So anybody has any question more? Okay. So the last team, moving towards the last team, team number 16, Pratik Dudhal's team, presenter Pratik itself and along with Omkar Mandal under the guidance of Professor B.B. Shaharkar sir. Pratik, towards you. Pratik, are you there? Or Omkar?
I think they are not there, all three.
Okay, ma'am. I think.
Who is that guide? Pratik.
It's a haircut, sir.
So yesterday they just called me, but I think they are not present.
No, but they should remain present at least, no. And whose guide is this other group?
Karpa, ma'am. Krishna group. For Krishna's team. Huh.
Actually, I had already told in the class and in the presentation sessions, we almost had three presentation meetings with the group leaders. I have already told you have to communicate to me in written and also to HOD and to guide. So, are nobody is there from the team? I mean, who is the team members?
Yes, Prateek.
Okay, I'll check in.
Mayur Tothar. Anybody is present currently?
No, I can't see any of them. I have taken down the attendance. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So.
Okay. So I think all presentations are finished. So moving towards the vote of thanks. So I will.
Just one minute, Prathamesh. Before you go for vote of thanks, sorry to interrupt you. I'll just say that I'll just give my inputs and then some faculties can give the inputs. I would request Lobo sir also to speak. So I would first of all say that all the students are very. Nice session, a big clap for you all the students and the ones who presented and the students behind the presentation who did not speak up directly. So all the teams have done very excellently. Okay, they have adjusted very well to this virtual online presentation. Like I can see really the output. So out of the 16 teams, 14 doing almost very well. Good presentation is really worth appreciable. Okay. And also following to the instructions, contacting the guide. Some students actually came to the college. So everything is going well. So hearty congratulations on that. And keep this up. That is the most important thing. Because as I told from day one, we are very serious about the projects and the presentations and also the publications that we expect from to come. Okay, so as Lobo sir said, yes, I myself will be giving the sessions on it for the presentations and the paper writing and everything. So once again, keep this up, and by the end of the day you will also get a feedback form which all the students have to fill. So if any of the faculties want to give any inputs, I just keep the forum open to them. Else Lobo sir will take up. And then we'll have the vote of thanks.
I really found your group to be enthusiastic and disciplined. So a great clap to you all. And you all have done a lot of hard work in a short period of time, which you had to actually start maybe 1 month back, but because of your TNP, you were a little bit diverted. But now take the things very seriously. Time is very short. And definitely we have a prediction in mind already. Okay, since we are all working, many of us are working into data mining and machine learning. We predict that your batch is going to show us very good results. Now this cannot be done unless you contact your guides once in 3 days, at least twice a week at least. Okay, and see that your projects are completed to a great extent. For those who have thought about representing their mini projects as a product, little bit more hard work will be required. And see that your report, which you are going to submit, for which you are going to be evaluated, of course, Ausikar Madam will tell you within 15 to 20 days, again, we'll have an evaluation wherein you'll have to submit your project report also. By a detailed study put into that project report. Okay. So you are going to plan very well and you're going to do this particular project very well, and your guides will always be there to guide you. So with this, I wish you all the best. It is not over. The session has just started and you have to work on your projects with great honesty. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, sir. Thank you, Lobo sir, and thank you, Ausikar ma'am, for giving the inputs. Okay, moving towards the vote of thanks, I will call upon Abhishek Gowri to give a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Prathamesh. So I would like to thank to our HOD sirs and all faculty members and project guides for their valuable time and listening to the student project ideas, which they have presented sincerely. So I would like to thank to the coordinators who coordinated this virtual project idea presentation successfully. At last, with the permission of the HOD sir and the CC Aushakar madam, I would declare that the project idea presentation is over. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, one and all. So with the permission of Lobo sir, shall I conclude the session and stop recording?
Yes. Yes. Okay, yes. Okay, madam. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Okay, thank you, all the faculty. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, dear students. So once again, appreciation. Thank you.